What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the "your account has been disabled" App Store error you are getting on your iPhone or iPad. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. In a lot of cases, this alert comes up when you've entered the wrong password multiple times, or when content and privacy restrictions are preventing you from using the App Store and iTunes. Completely exit out of the App Store and open up your settings. From here, tap on your Apple ID name and make sure that you're logged in with the correct account. To make sure that there are no current issues with your Apple ID, proceed to sign out and, after a couple of seconds, proceed to log back into your account. When this is done, head back to your main settings and tap on Screen Time. Under Content and Privacy Restrictions, select iTunes and App Store Purchases. Here, you should allow installing and deleting apps as well as in-app purchases. Alternatively, you can also completely disable content and privacy restrictions to prevent these issues from coming up in the future. Next, navigate to your general settings. Here, tap on Date and Time and make sure that the Set Automatically option is enabled. If disabled, your iOS device can prevent your account from making purchases in the App Store or completely disable your account. Under Software Update, make sure to download and install the latest iOS update. This will, in most cases, require you to be connected to a power source as well as a Wi-Fi connection. Your device will then restart, which will restart all processes running on your iPhone and can fix the "account has been disabled" problem you are facing. In case nothing helps you out, then head back to your iPhone settings. Here, tap on your Apple ID name and select Media and Purchases, and then View Account. You should proceed to sign in with your Apple ID password or Face ID. Under Manage Payments, proceed to remove your current payment method and add it again to make sure that it's working and up to date. This will help you if you have not been signed in for a longer period of time or if there are billing issues such as outstanding bills to be paid. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.